Hi, my candidate. I am Flash Isaac, and welcome to Commerce Syllabus with Flash Isaac. Today, I'll be taking you through the things you are supposed to read in WAEC Commerce. And trust me, if you are determined and you read consistently, you'll be able to cover your Commerce Syllabus and come out with an A. The WAEC Commerce Syllabus is actually not complicated. It's straightforward and it's compact. So I'll take you through the syllabus so that you know the things you are supposed to read so long commerce is concerned in WAEC. Alright, now take a look at the commerce syllabus for WAEC. The first thing you should know is the introduction to commerce, definition of commerce, the history of commerce, scope and function of commerce. So if you know all these things about commerce, you've started. Basically, the act of buying and selling of goods and rendering services. That's what commerce is mainly about. Okay, why e-commerce is when you are doing all those things, buying and selling online. That's what e-commerce. Good. If you know that, you started commerce. Then the next thing you should know in commerce is occupation. What are occupation and what are the types of occupation? You should know about production. What's the meaning of production and what are the factors of production? Factors of production are land, labor, capital, and entrepreneur. Land is fees, and the reward for land is rent. The reward for labor is wages and salary. Capital, the reward for capital is interest. While the entrepreneur is someone who mobilizes other factors of production to ensure everything moves smoothly. If you know about business unit, so proprietorship, partnership, public corporation, public limited liability company, and so on. And as an SPO, sole proprietorship is one man business, and the death of the businessman is most time the end of the business. Partnership, people partner, and we have public liability companies, public enterprises. You should know about all these business units. Cool? Good. You should know about trade associations, how different associations come, different people come back, come together, selling similar products to determine how the business moves forward. You should know about business capital, profit and loss. Then you should know about trade, home trade and foreign trade. Home trade is trade within the country. Foreign trade involves two or more countries. It is also called international trade, which is, it involves import and export. When you take goods to other countries, you are exporting. When you are bringing goods from other countries, you are importing. Then there is something called entry ports. When you export already imported goods, you import goods from other country to a country and re-export it to another country. That's entry port. And in international trade, there's actually tariffs and other things you need to pay on the way, custom duties and so on. And these things go a long way to affect the price of the goods. Is that okay? Alright, let's see the next topic. You know, in commerce for WAEC. You should know about purchase and sales of goods in home and foreign trade, finance and financial institutions. So you should know about banks, insurance, money, capital market, stock exchange, commodity exchange. Then you should know transportation, tourism, communication and warehousing. So these things, they aid your trade, they help in preservation of goods, storage of goods, and production of goods. They should know about aids to trade, which are marketing and marketing concepts to help you to boost in the sales of goods produced. Should know about legal aspects of business. There's something else you should know is economic grouping, like ECOWAS, Lake Basin Commission, European Union, and West African Clearing House. Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe. Watch my other